What's up, sports bettors? Constantly on the hunt for good bets. I'm going to be sharing with you another play that I'm rolling with. I love betting on college football. It's back. We have week zero, but my bet is on week one. So the play I'm going with, you can see it's a positive EV bet. So it's mathematically profitable, right? It's a bit lower on the page, but you can see right here, positive EV bets. It just means mathematically profitable bets, right? The way that Odds Jam works is pretty simple. It constantly scans all of these lines across sportsbooks, updating millions of odds in real time to show you bets that have a positive profit margin. And if you're wondering, how is that even possible? Kind of the best way to think about it is if we kind of look at, like, let's say the Sean O'Malley, Piotr Jan fight, right? Like, looking at the betting odds, most sportsbooks are pricing Jan from minus 365 to minus 420. So if someone put a gun to your head and said, hey, bet this minus 200, you'd probably want to put the house on him minus 200, given the fact that every other sportsbook is pricing this around minus 400. In the same way, if someone gave you Sean O'Malley plus 1,000, if there was some DraftKings promo or something, obviously that bet's ridiculously profitable. No other sportsbook's giving you better than, you know, plus 300. So being able to get, you know, Sean O'Malley plus 330, although it's less extreme of an example, is a sharp bet with a positive profit margin. So anyways, let's go to the play. Here's another play I locked in. If you like the UFC, Benoit St. Denis, I think I hit this, I forget exactly when, but I think I hit this as well. So I love betting on the UFC. I have $450 on this play. Lines have been moving towards him. So UFC has some pretty insane line movement. So if you're able to, like, you know, constantly be looking for good bets, what you'll notice is here, DraftKings moved the line on St. Denis from like minus 230 all the way up to minus 260. Same with BetOnline and Pinnacle. So all the sharp sportsbooks have taken a ton of action clearly on Benoit St. Denis. And being able to get minus 225 at this point is a ridiculously profitable bet compared to the rest of the betting market, right? So as a sharp bettor, you're always looking for value. And this is a play with value. But let's go back to my Arizona bet. So I'm on Arizona +6.5. On the point spread, and we can see the reason I love this so much is what you'll notice is BetOnline and Pinnacle, so two of the sharpest sportsbooks in the world, are pricing Arizona +5.5 as minus 110 and minus 109 respectively. So essentially, BetOnline and Pinnacle are a full point away from FanDuel on the spread. Right, so FanDuel is not even going to let me bet for a college football point spread. They're only giving me $220. They're like, yo, Alex, you make too much money off us. So I'm just going to place $220 on it. But regardless, I like the bet. And, you know, my goal as a sharp bettor is place as many bets with an edge as possible on a daily basis. So what we can see here is, right, like the two sharpest bookmakers are setting the spread at +5.5. We're getting Arizona +6.5. So if Arizona loses by exactly 6 points, which is a big number, you know, in college football, that's like a key number in college football. The game ends by two field goals, whatever. We win, right? Everyone betting on the sharp sportsbooks, the sharp offshore sportsbooks, loses, right? So even though that extra point in value, like, oh, will Arizona actually lose by exactly 6 points, doesn't seem like it matters. Just wait, right? There will be a time in the season, if you're not line shopping, where you bet something, you know, +2.5 when you could have gotten +3.5, and your bet's going to lose because your team's going to lose by a field goal, right? It's going to happen. So line shopping is so easy, first of all. It's literally just browsing odds and will make all the difference in terms of your net profit in the long run. What has made me, you know, $400,000 sports betting, whatever, like a very successful sports bettor, is just being able to always make sure I'm getting great prices and, you know, beat the closing line, right? Because if you're beating the closing line, you're going to make money in the long run as a sharp bettor. It's all about looking for value. So hopefully you found this video helpful. Let's make money.